these teams, 1-1 in the 1987 season. We are just about set for the opening kickoff. Penn State won the toss and deferred, so they will be kicking off to begin the football game. They'll have their choice in the second half this afternoon. So it will be the Bearcats from Cincinnati receiving on a cold, gray, drizzly afternoon in University Park. The wind is not a factor. The temperature is very cool, and we could have some rain. Here are the officials for this afternoon's ball game. The man you will see most often is called Schmidt, the referee. 6 for the Nittany Lions of Penn State.
And Reed put a nice block playing in a fullback position. I'm sure he's not used to blocking in that position, but he put a nice block in the defensive end and allowed Thomas to make that gain.
The fifth meeting between these two teams, Penn State leads the series 3-1, and the Nittany Lions have won the last 2 years. Thomas now 3 carries, 13 yards.
Brand new fullback Green. And he looks good, as I said before, he was involved in four lot of productive plays in that drive.
The penalty is indeed against the Bearcats from the University of Cincinnati in Cincinnati, Ohio. Their head coach, Dave Curry, in his fourth season, overall 12 years of coaching. He's 53-58 as a head coach. Long goal, all the way back to the 11-yard line.
John, every quarterback that Coach Curry coached has gone into the pros. And he coached the Heisman Trophy winner.
Double tight ends. Bill Davis, the lone wide
particular injury. And they had a trips formation, and the receiver and the quarterback were not on the right page.
That is coached deep to receive.
Realizes it's too early in the game to take chances, especially with a wet ball. stay line. It was a trap by, I believe, the Struzzi. And they're going up the middle against that 4-3, which is the weakness of the 4-3.
Is indeed another first down. 79 yards down for Thomas here in the first quarter. 13 seconds left. This could be the last play in the first quarter. Now Brett switches sides. Third down and goal. Walter Johnson, the junior, worms its way inside the 10 before it is finally fielded by Castillo. He falls down at the 14-yard line. Poor field position coming up for the Bearcats.
There's an instance where Penn State got a break on this. They got a chance to kick it twice. You get a squib right in the middle. Ball is very difficult to handle. Castillo finally gets it, and you can see how slick and how poor the field conditions are.
At the 14, McKinney, the tailback, straight ahead. He will not get to the 15-yard line. He is ridden down on the play by Matt Johnson with some help from Pete Giftopoulos. Remember, Giftopoulos playing outside this afternoon.
He's 237 pounds. He's certainly capable of it. The big thing about Giftopoulos, he's starting to get healthy. The 90% that's Giftopoulos is better than most linebackers in the country.
No gain on that play. It'll be second down 10 for the Bearcats. McCoy is still the quarterback, despite the fact that he is working with a slight knee injury. He has Davis, his all-purpose, back in there right now. The wide receiver, he'll be split to the top of the screen. They still look with Huber and Williams in the double tight end. McCoy, pressure rolls, throws, complete, down at the 25-yard line. That is Davis, Bill Davis, a junior from Berea, Ohio. Cincinnati, but back at the line of scrimmage is where the original infraction occurred.
defense will go to that particular flanker. They come back to the short side, and freshman Brown makes an unsizable game.
And we also have Sam Gash, number